Good evening everybody and welcome to my latest model train review video. Finally, my Athearn ready to run Norfolk Southern liveried General Electric -9 that is also known as the C44-9W, or I think this variant could be the C40-9W. But either way, they're commonly known as a -9. This model arrived to me today, all the way from the United States, as it did take a while to clear customs for some reason. But when I inspected the model, I was a little bit disappointed to find that one of the dummy ditch lights had came loose in the box, along with another part of the model, which is loose in the tray, which should be firmly fitted to the model. Compared to my US made Athearn -7, which is quite an old model, the details on that model are very robust, but sadly it doesn't seem to be the case with this newer made in China model. But still, it's a entry level model and they do sell for around $100, although I did pick this one up for about $80 brand new from an eBay store. But the problem was that the handrails on the sides weren't firmly fitted into the model, and to find a dummy ditch light as well as another part from the model loose in the tray, I am a little bit disappointed with the quality control of Athearn. So I may still buy a couple of more of their models, but I'm a little bit put off their range because of this issue. But still, excuse me, sorry guys, I have refitted the dummy ditch light with my tweezers, which is a simple push fit, and I have firmly refitted the handrails so that the model now looks as it should do when it leaves the factory. I've got a piece of track that I'm going to display the model on. But on a positive note though, the model is well packed. You've got a plastic sleeve with a divisible tray, which is also plastic, so the model is well protected while in storage. But why this model was allowed to leave the factory with those defects, I don't know. But anyway, rant over, let's unbox the model, let's have a look at the beast in the flesh. Now, upon removing the model from the box, you've got this stunning Norfolk Southern livery. You've got the instructions in the box, which tells you what parts and stuff you can buy if ever you need to replace any of the parts, which I think you'd need to contact Athearn in the United States directly for that. But let's put the two trays over there in the background, and let's have a look at the beast in the flesh. Likewise, I'm going to pop that over there and removing the top part of the lid, we can now see the model. And it certainly does look a beast, even though it's sitting on the lower part of its tray. So, let's take the model off the tray and remove the trays to a safe place. Then I can move the model around on the track. As you can see, just for the record, there's the spare part that has come off the model. I'm assuming it's part of the chassis or something. So I will consult the instructions a bit later on after I've done this review, and I'll try and refit that part myself. But anyways, moving back to the model, I'm going to lower the camera and then we can zoom in onto the numbers and the parts. The fleet number of this particular dash 9 is numbered as 9746, and the front of the model is quite different, as the window shrouds is white rather than just black like the rest of the livery is. Well, the main body colour anyway. You've also got the two vent grills here, which are also etched onto the model. You've got a nice stunning livery on the actual locomotive as well. And I do like Norfolk Southern, which is why I chose this model. You've also got the cooling group, complete with the K5LA horns, the exhaust outlet, and the cooling fans towards the rear of the locomotive. I think that's a... whoops. Just zooming slowly. As I was saying, I think that centrepiece is either a brake wheel or something like that. As I think these locomotives do have handbrakes as well as standard air brakes and that kind of thing. You've also got like the horse logo next to the Norfolk Southern banner on the side of the locomotive. So the detail is quite nice and it's not bad for an entry level model, but because of the quality issues, I will not be giving this model a very high score, I'm afraid. As for the price I paid for the model, and considering it's brand new, I am not too impressed with the build quality. But I am going to do a separate video of this locomotive, my Kato SD40, and my older US made Dash 7 in Union Pacific, running on the test tracks in a separate video. So running wise, you'll all be able to see it in that video, which will be uploaded separately after this one. So if I just turn the track around, I'll give you a good look at the front, and also we can have a look at the cab better as well. I think that's a radio aerial on the top of the cab there. You've also got the fleet numbers above the cab windows as well. I think these are also referred to in the United States as road numbers. 9746 above both cab windows. You've also got a working headlight on the front of the nose, which is just next to the driver's cab access door, complete with a nice wraparound frontal logo, complete with a horse. Kind of looks similar to the Lloyds Bank one from the 80s. But that's another story anyway. If I just zoom out a little bit, you've got nicely fitted handrails and grab rails on the top of the bonnet, as well as steps to the left hand side, which I think that would allow the maintenance crew and that to clean the locomotive's windows or something like that anyway. And also you've got the dummy ditch lights and you've got the snow plough and a working knuckle type coupler as well, which are also known as Buckeye couplers in the UK. I do plan to make these ditch lights into working ones by drilling out the headlight boxes and fitting working LEDs inside them. A bit similar to how a tutorial video shows you, which is elsewhere on YouTube. So thanks to the poster who posted that video for giving me some inspirations on how to upgrade this model. I also might fit a crew inside the cab as well. So I do hope there's a cab interior. If not, I will source one from a spare model. Anyways, excuse me, that concludes my review of the Athearn Ready to Run Norfolk Southern General Electric -9 diesel freight locomotive. My overall score rating for this model, because of the poor build quality, I'm only going to give this 5 out of 10. Otherwise, if it had been intact with no defects, I would have given the model a close 8 out of 10. Well, that concludes my review. If you have any comments or questions, please feel free to post them in the comment section below, and thank you for watching. Have a good weekend, and stay tuned for another video coming soon.